this video we will have another subscriber request. This time I got an email from one of my subscribers, Joa. So Joa wanted to see the way how to calculate the angle AFE from this sketch. So since this was really nice geometry angle problem, I decided to put it in a video. So thank you, Joa, for your wonderful suggestion. But before we start solving this problem, I will first try to replicate it to the best of my abilities. So we basically start with a circle, and we will pull the vertical diameter of this circle and we will label it as AD. Next, on the right part of the arc of our circle, we will insert two points B and C in such a way so that the lines AB, BC, and CD are equal. Now, on the left part of the arc of our circle, we will insert the point E in such a way so that the arcs EA and ED are equal. Now, we will pull a line from the point E to the point B. And let's label the intersection point between this line and the diameter of our circle as F. The question is, can we somehow calculate the angle AFE, or let's label it as theta? So if you guys want to try this interesting problem for yourself, you can pause the video right now and then come back and check the solution. All right, so let's solve this one. So I will offer you two different methods to solve this problem. The first method will include one really interesting intersecting chords angle theorem. So I will start by connecting the lines EA and ED, since those lines were in the original sketch as well. Now, due to the fact that the arc EA is equal to the arc ED, this means that the lines EA and ED are equal as well, since those lines represent the corresponding chords of those arcs. Next, I will label the center of our circle as O, and I will simplify our image so that we will only keep the left side of it. Now, you can notice that the angle at the point E is a right angle. But how do we know this? Well, we will use an inscribed angle theorem. This theorem states that an angle, which we will label as theta, inscribed in a circle is half of the central angle, in this case 2 theta, that intercepts the same arc on the circle. So if I label all the vertices on the sketch on the right the same as the sketch on the left, you can notice that we have the similar situation here. Our central angle at the point O is actually 180 degrees. So this means that the angle at the point E must be the half of the 180 degrees, which is 90 degrees. Now, with this in mind, we can notice that the triangle EAD is actually an isosceles right triangle. So this triangle represents the half of the square. Now, if we pull the horizontal diagonal of our square, it will also represent the diameter of a circle. But more importantly for us, it will bisect our other diagonal AD at the right angle. Now, with this knowledge, let's go back to our original sketch, and this time we will get rid of the left side and we will only leave the right side of the sketch. Now first, let's pull the lines OB and OC. And now let's notice that since the lines AB, BC, and CD are equal, this means that the arcs AB, BC, and CD will have to be equal as well. So, from this, we can conclude that the angle at the point O is actually divided into three identical angles of 60 degrees. Now, since the lines OA, OB, and OC are actually radii of our circle, this means that those three triangles are congruent and furthermore, they represent an isosceles triangles with the 60 degree angle at the apex. So this means that those three triangles are actually an equilateral triangles. This is kind of illogical, because if we mirror the image on the right side, you can see that we will get a regular hexagon which is inscribed inside our circle. And the regular hexagon consists out of six equilateral triangles. Alright, so now let's go back and let's only keep angles BOC and COD as you can see on the sketch. Now let's go back to our previous sketch, and now we will use an awesome intersecting chords angle theory. This theorem states that when two chords intersect inside the circle, the measure of an angle formed by the chords is half of the sum of the angle measures of the intercepted arcs. So the formula will look something like this, where the angles EA and BD are actually central angles formed by those arcs. So I have labeled the sketch on the right the same way as the sketch on the left. So if we simplify the sketch on the left a little bit, you can see that we have an identical situation. So we can use this formula in our case. We can say that the angle theta is actually equal 1/2 of the central angle underneath the arc EA, which is 90 degree angle, plus the central angle underneath the arc BD, which is, as you can see, 2 times the 60 degree angle or 120 degree angle. So this means that the angle theta is nothing but the 1/2 of 210 degrees, which means that our angle theta has the value of 105 degrees, and this is our solution. So what if you haven't heard about this interesting theorem? Is there another way to solve this problem? And the answer is yes, and I'm going to show you this right now. But before I do this, this would be a great time to invite you guys to like the video and subscribe to the channel if you liked the content so far. Those stuff really means a lot. And of course, if you have a comment or a question, please leave it in the comment section below. Alright, so now let me show you the second method, which will not include the intersecting chord angle theorem. So we are going to start by labeling the center of our circle as O. Then let's simplify our sketch and focus on the right side. Again, I will pull two lines from the point O to the point B and from the point O to the point C. And from the previous method, we have proven that this right side of our sketch is nothing but the half of the regular hexagon, which means that the triangle OBC is an equilateral triangle. Of course, like I said, I have proven this already in method number 1, so I'm not going to waste your time and prove this all over again. So we know that the angle at the point O of this triangle must be 60 degree angle. Now let's go ahead and pull the line from the point E to the point C. Now let me simplify our image once more. And now let's focus at the angle at the point E. We will again use the same inscribed angle theorem which we used in the previous method, which states that the peripheral angle must be the half of the value of the central angle. So as you can see, I have labeled the points on the sketch on the right the same as the sketch on the left. And in this case, our central angle has the value of 60 degrees, which means that the peripheral angle will have to be the half of this, so the angle at the point E will be 30 degree angle. Now let's focus on the right side. We know that the triangle EDA is an isosceles right triangle. We have also proven this in the previous method, and we know that it represents the half of the square. So if we pull the horizontal diagonal of this square, this diagonal must be perpendicular to the diagonal AD. Now, we know that the lines AD and BC are parallel. This is due to the fact that the line BC represents the side of the regular hexagon and the line AD represents the corresponding diagonal of this hexagon. This implies that the angle between our horizontal diameter OE and the line BC must be right angle as well. Now we will use one really interesting property of a circle, which states that the perpendicular to a chord drawn from the center of the circle bisects the chord. This means that the extended line EO actually bisects the line BC. So this implies that this line EO will also bisect the angle at the point E, and it will divide it into two angles of 15 degrees. Now let's simplify our image for the better understanding, and let's use the values that we have. Let's take a look at the triangle EOF, and we will use an interesting property of the angles of the triangle, which states that an exterior angle of a triangle is equal to the sum of two opposite interior angles. As you can see, this is perfect for our case here, because we can calculate the angle theta as the sum of two interior angles at the point E and O. So, since the value of those two angles are 15 degrees and 90 degrees, we can conclude that the angle theta is equal to 105 degrees, and again, we have the same solution. So, if you guys found any other way to solve this interesting problem, please make sure to write it down in the comment section below. And again, until next time, see you all and take care.